Hello everybody, my name is Walter and this is the first episode of Marathon Origins series. In this episode I will talk about the costs of the various redstone components. I will compare those costs for the various raw materials, and while doing so I will also hint towards the redstone components you should keep an eye open for when designing your own contraptions, because they represent somewhat of a possible hidden cost within your builds, which you wouldn't expect at the beginning of your designing process. Now with that general introduction out of the way, let's quickly talk about how to interpret those walls here. Basically, each of those chunks here of item frames represents one raw material and the comparison of the redstone components for that material. At the bottom of each, you have the material itself. So in this case here, it would be wood logs. Then a general idea of how you can get that material, so chopping down some trees for wood, for example. And then on top of that, you have the various redstone components that use said material with the costs for a single unit of said component. Of course, for example, here you would get a quarter stack with each time you craft one of those. So you have to modify or multiply this number with 16. Before you have the actual costs you will need for the initial crafting. But anyway, that's basically the idea behind this entire thing. So you start with the cheapest one in this corner here, then you go up with the costs, and so on, until you reach the most expensive one in this corner here. Additionally, as you can see here, I have marked several of those components here with a different background, and the reason for that is that those components here will, depending on what type of contraption you build, likely make up a big chunk of the actual costs of the entire thing. So this of course depends on what type of contraption you're building. So a flying machine will, for example, need pistons, but it won't need any chests or hoppers or such things. So it's situation dependent. Anyway, that's basically the explanation of how this thing here works. If you're interested in those numbers, you can also find them in an Excel table I made, the download link for which you can find in the description of this video. That table is sortable, so you can just go through this table and then sort them however you want and have essentially the same information as you will have in this video here. Anyway, that's enough of the introduction, so let's get straight to the comparisons. And for that, let's start with wood, which you get from chopping trees, of course, and which is interestingly enough used in more redstone components than redstone itself is used in. So just a little fun effect on the side here. Anyway, let's get through this comparison here. So you can see the various components here. The costs you can get from either downloading this world here or just downloading the Excel table. And I will just talk about those blocks or components I've marked down there. Anyway, the first I've marked are the pistons. So the normal piston and the sticky piston, simply due to the fact that they need quite a bit of wood actually, as at least in comparison to those components here. And they can be quite numerous in contraptions where you move blocks around. So flying machines, doors, or certain type of mob farms, since they can also move entities around. Then we have the wooden trapdoor, which is used in certain type of mob farms due to the fact that mobs think of them as valid ground to stand on, even if they are opened. Then we have the chest and the hopper. And especially the hopper is quite numerous in storage systems or item sorting systems, which means that those components here make a big chunk of the wooden costs in your builds. Next up we have stone and cobblestone, which get from mining, although the stone you will need either to get from a smelter or you will need a silk touch pickaxe. Anyway, for the stone I've marked the repeater and the comparator, simply due to the fact that they are quite expensive concerning stone, and they can be quite numerous in more complex circuitry. The same goes for the observer, which is not only expensive concerning the cobblestone, but it's also a very common occurrence, for example, in flying machines or basically any kind of more complex circuitry. Then next up we have finally the redstone dust, which you get again from mining. Here I've marked down redstone wire itself, because it's quite easy to underestimate the amount of redstone wire you have in bigger circuitry. And if you just make a guesstimate, you will be quite a bit lower than the actual need. Or at least this is what I have found in my contraptions. Anyway, the next ones I've marked down are again the repeater and the comparator, due to similar reasons as before. So again, they need quite a bit of redstone dust and they can be quite numerous. And then we have the most expensive one, which is the redstone block here, which I again have marked down simply due to the fact that it's very expensive concerning the redstone dust to just craft one of them. And concerning certain very compact designs, they can be even quite numerous in those contraptions. So this is pretty much of a double whammy here. Following that, we have iron, which you get from mining the ore and then smelting it down. Here I've marked the normal rail, since if you have a railway system in your base, this will be quite a factor concerning costs, since you will need quite a lot of those. Then next I have marked the pistons, again due to similar reasons as before, which are the big number of those in certain type of builds, and also that they are not that cheap concerning iron. And lastly, I've marked for the normal redstone components the hopper once more, again due to their overall use in storage or item sorting systems, and even more here due to the high cost of iron. Additionally, we have minecarts, which combined with a hopper make a hopper minecart, which even costs the double amount of iron in comparison with the hopper here. And this can be also quite a factor for certain type of farms, which use those to collect the items. So this is also something to keep in mind. Then closely connected to that, we have gold, which you also get from mining the ore and smelting it down. Here the thing to keep an eye open for is the powered rail, which is used in various contraptions, either for example to transport the hopper minecart in the specific farm types, or even as a kind of system to transport a redstone signal. So if you have watched any video from Elmango, you will have seen those used quite often as a replacement for redstone wire. So this is also something to keep an eye open for. And as you can see, you will need basically one gold ingot to get one powered rail. So this is not really that cheap, actually. Then we have nether quartz, which you get from mining in the nether, of course, and which is used to, for example, craft observers, which once more are part of many types of circuitry and, for example, flying machines. Furthermore, I've marked the daylight sensor here simply due to the fact that you need three nether quartz to craft only one of those, and they can be used quite numerous in certain type of landscaping projects, for example, as part of automatic streetlights. Following that, let's get to the slime ball, which you get from killing slimes, at least the small slimes, and which is used to craft the sticky piston and the slime block, which is not really a redstone component itself, but it is a part of so many redstone contraptions that I'm actually counting it as a kind of redstone component itself. And, well, I've marked it down here simply since it's very expensive, as you can see there, and it's also used in immense amounts in, for example, very big vault doors and flying machines. Following that, we have sand, which you can find on beaches or in deserts, and glass, which you can smelt from the sand, which are used in the daylight sensor, which again is part of certain types of landscaping projects or cityscaping projects, and then TNT. And I have marked TNT here simply due to the fact, unless you're using a duplication glitch, any usage of TNT is, in my opinion at least, a big waste of resources, simply due to the fact that it's a one-use-only contraption. But that's my personal opinion anyway. Following that, we have the string, which is used to craft bows, which are used to craft the dispenser. The string you can get from spiders. An alternative would be to get the bow directly from the skeleton. Then we have the book or the leather, which you can use to craft a book, which then you can use to craft a bookshelf, and then that can be used to craft a lectern. So this is also maybe some kind of a hidden cost, but since you don't use that many lecterns usually, this is not really a hidden cost in my opinion. But the next one is, which is the glowstone, which you get again from mining in the Nether, and which is used to craft redstone lamps. And those once more can be used in combination with the daylight sensor as an automatic light source, so cityscaping or landscaping projects, and they are also used in, for example, complexer circuitry to give a feedback to the user. And last but not least, we have gunpowder, which you get, of course, from killing creepers. And this is once more used to craft TNT, which I already mentioned is somewhat of a waste unless you use a duplication glitch. And with that, we have pretty much reached the end of this episode here. Again, if you are interested in the actual numbers for those comparisons here, you can find them by either downloading this world or the corresponding Excel sheet. Links for those in the description of this video. I hope I was able to sensitize you towards possible hidden costs with redstone contraptions you might build or design in the future. I also hope I didn't bore you too much with this video. And, well, see ya!